Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing really well today. So I am back today to talk a little bit about my year without fast fashion. If you've been following my channel since this time last year, I made a video talking about how I wanted to give up fast fashion and not buy new clothes for a year other than thrifting and then sewing my own clothes. So I've just finished that year-long experiment and I'm really excited to share with you guys some reflections on that today. I've also collected some questions from Instagram that I will go over at the end. So I'm just gonna go ahead and jump right in and tell you how this year went for me. So it's been really interesting to think back on now that I've finished the year without buying clothes because it was really difficult in the beginning. In the beginning, I realized how much I shopped online. I think that was a big time waster for me. Something that I just filled my time with was scrolling what was new on all of my favorite retailers. And so I realized that that was something I was spending a lot of time doing. And once I stopped doing that, it became so much easier to not want to buy new clothes because I wasn't seeing what was new all the time. I did also unsubscribe from a lot of email lists at the beginning of the year, so I wouldn't be seeing the constant bombardment of new collections from different shops. But it was really interesting to me to realize how much I was actually online shopping, even without buying anything. It was just like I felt this need to scroll through and see what was new on websites. So as I broke that habit, I found that I had so much more free time for more creative thinking. So that was definitely a benefit of stopping buying new clothes. So when I started this experiment at the beginning of the year, I think that what I thought would happen was that I would fill my need for retail therapy with thrift shopping. But with the way that 2020 unfolded, that was not something that I ended up doing a lot of at all. I did make some different orders on ThredUp and also did a few thrift shopping trips kind of at the beginning of the year and then a few here and there recently, but that was not a big part of my year at all. But what I did do this year was I rediscovered my love for sewing my own clothes, which is something that I have done off and on over the past several years, but I really got into it this year, as I'm sure you guys noticed if you have been following my channel. It's kind of now a sewing channel, which I don't think it had as much direction at the beginning of this past year, which I think has been a really great benefit for me. I feel like I have more of a direction in the content I create because I am so inspired to do sewing. So that's been really exciting for me and a wonderful benefit of stopping buying clothes. So you might be wondering if I cheated at all throughout this whole process, and I did make two exceptions to the rule throughout the year. One was actually a caveat that I included in my original video. I spent a gift card to buy a new pair of jeans. They were fair trade jeans from Madewell. So that was one purchase that I made. And then the other one was in the summer when I realized that I would be staying home a lot more and I was really getting into running. I bought some new running clothes from Girlfriend Collective, which is a ethical company that makes their clothes from recycled water bottles. So I felt good about both of those purchases, but those were the two exceptions to my rule. One other thing that I've realized as I've gone throughout this process is that in the past, I've had no idea what I wanted when it came to clothes, and I was really waiting for different clothing companies to tell me what I wanted by what they were creating. So that's been a big change for me as I've gone from just looking for what was new to looking for inspiration for creating what I actually have envisioned in my mind. It has been a big change. And I really love that because I feel like the clothes that I now have are embodying more of my own style rather than just being whatever is new at Madewell on a given day. So I'm really excited about that change as well. So overall, I would say that I had a really positive experience. I kind of broke my online shopping habit, which was great. I also feel renewed in my creativity and a lot more inspired to create my own items. And also like I have more direction with my YouTube channel, which is really a great outcome. There were a few times over the past year where I had some trouble sticking to my rule because I would see some of my favorite companies having sales and different people posting about it on Instagram. But I did come to realize that if I could just, you know, ignore that I would not feel like I missed out at all. So definitely a learning experience in a lot of ways, and I'm really glad that I did this experiment. So with all of that said, let's move over to some questions from Instagram. One question that I got several times was, how did the process affect your budget? And at the beginning of the year, I had actually been thinking about going to go back to school and get a master's degree. And so my budget was something that was part of my reasoning for trying this experiment in the first place. But throughout 2020, I came to realize that that was not a priority for me at this point in my life. And as I got into making the sewing videos, I would say that buying fabric probably equaled the amount that I would spend on clothes. I didn't keep a really strict watch on it in terms of my budget, but I would say it was probably just a negligible difference. And because I was putting the sewing into making the videos, it felt a little bit more productive. So I didn't feel bad about spending the money on it. There were a couple of questions about if I was able to make or thrift everything that I found myself wanting for my style. One of the questions was, how do you not stress about finding your style? I feel like there's more pressure when you're shopping less. And then another question was, could you make or find in a thrift shop everything that you wanted throughout the year? And I would say yes, for the most part. I at least wanted to try making things myself. And if I had a really specific idea of something I wanted to buy secondhand, then ThredUp and Poshmark usually worked pretty well for that. So I don't think that was really an issue. It definitely takes more effort if you have a really specific thing in mind. And then if you see something that's trendy on Instagram, it can be difficult to find something that's exactly the same. Especially with secondhand shopping, because the pieces are generally older. So with trendy items, I would say I found myself sewing more, and with more classic pieces, it was more of the thrift shopping. This question is, what was the hardest part of the challenge for you? So like I talked about earlier, the beginning was really difficult as I was getting myself away from online shopping. That was definitely a habit that I had to break. And then apart from that, I would say just seeing things on Instagram and wanting to buy them was probably difficult. So I found myself using Instagram a lot less this year as well, scrolling through less, because I would just see things that I wanted to buy. So if I found myself in the mode where I was looking for inspiration, that was not a big deal. But if I found myself kind of wanting to shop, then that could definitely be a trigger for me. Is not shopping fast fashion something you plan to continue? Why or why not? So I plan to continue this for the most part going forward, but I won't be as strict with myself, I guess is how I would put it. So I definitely feel like I've broken the habit and the need to buy new things and to buy kind of what is prescribed from different retailers. But I do also feel like if I want to buy a new sweater or something, I'm not going to have a hard and fast rule about it. I think that doing this experiment has really helped me to realign my perspective on shopping. So it's more about looking for what I actually need or want instead of just shopping for the sake of shopping. So I think I'm just going to come to it with a new perspective. But for the most part, I would say I will still be sticking with making and thrifting my clothes for now, because it's something that I'm able to do and something that I enjoy doing. What made you want to change and do this process? There were a few things, and I think I detailed this in my video from last year. As I said before, my budget was originally a part of it because I was thinking about going to grad school, but that's kind of become a moot point at this point. And then also just wanting to see if it was possible for me, see how much it would affect me, how much shopping was a part of my life. So I've definitely gotten answers to a lot of the questions I had about that at the beginning of the year. And then also just to boost my creativity. I love the quote that constraint breeds creativity, because I think that is so true. And I've definitely seen that throughout the past year. And then one last question for today, where do you thrift locally? Just in case you guys are in the Central Arkansas or Little Rock area. I have three favorite thrift shops. One is the Goodwill on Markham. I think that one has the most variety, and it's not as organized as some of the others, but there is definitely the most turnaround there, and you'll find newer items more often. And then I also like the Goodwill on Cantrell. That one is newer and is a lot more organized. It doesn't have as much to pick from. And then one other thrift shop is the Our House thrift shop, which is, I think, also on Markham. I will link to the location down below. This one's smaller. My friend Lee from Lee Thrifts introduced me to this one, and it benefits Our House. And they have a lot of great pieces there as well. So I think that is going to be it for this video, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this kind of wrap up of this process. Let me know if you have any further questions down below, and I will do my best to answer them. And let me know if this is something that you guys are thinking about this next year, maybe reducing your shopping or fast fashion or something of that nature. I would love to hear about your journey and your process with that. Thank you so much for watching and spending your time here on my channel today. If you are interested in following my fashion journey through sewing and thrifting, that is what I share here on my channel. So you can subscribe if you're interested, and I would love to have you along for future videos. You can also follow me on Instagram and TikTok. My username will be here, and it is the same on both platforms. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching and spending your time here today, and I will talk to you in the next one. Bye.